Alrighty guys, I'm Orthodon and we are here for Fairy Tail Final Season, episode 292. Spooky. So I made some bad choices and ended up taking a nap, which is actually something I normally do, but I slept way longer than planned, so it's really late at night right now, so I'm a little loopy, and I literally like I usually try to give myself a little bit after I wake up before I record, but I jumped out of bed when I saw the time, and I was like, "Crap, I gotta record tonight." So, yeah, that's what's up. So last episode we had the invasion begin, and we had Urza versing Agil for a little bit. She seemed to be in big trouble. I didn't talk about that much in my discussion, mostly because I figure she's gonna be fine, but you know, who knows with this being the final season. But she's definitely gonna like be more badass than that before she goes out, so I don't think she's dead or anything. But yeah, so, and then we found out that they're coming in from all four directions, and they are very, very, very in right, like large numbers. It seems like, I think it was it all 12? I'm not sure if it was all 12 of them. I believe they said it was three more from all four directions, but I'm not sure if three are included in the one, in like the first direction that they came in already. So is it three other directions? Which well no, that's still, never mind, that so that still equals 12 if it is. I'm dumb. Okay. Anyway, I guess we'll just get into this and see what happens. Alrighty, so we are gonna start the episode in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 now. All right. Oh, they're gonna tell us a little bit of the format. Cool. Okay, yeah, so this is some recap. And also we're not gonna watch the intro or anything. Actually, in fact, while this recap goes on, I'm gonna minimize that on my other window. Yep. That's right, a wall broke in through the wall. Okay. I actually didn't realize that Gray and Juvia were headed to that guy. Oh, yeah. Oh no. Oh, it's so cool how they're just flying through the damn boats. That's such a cool animation choice. Oh, I love it. Yeah, we have a zero chance of winning. It is a long recap, but I guess I set up a lot. They want to make sure everybody has an idea of what's going on and remember all the pieces on the board and stuff like that. Because now we're gonna get the intro, right? Yep. Okay. Minimizing so I do not see the intro. I didn't realize this intro started with some English. I didn't notice that last time. I think I was so panicked trying to minimize it last time, so I wasn't ready for it. Is it like me and you? And I was like, wait, is this an English song? The intro's wearing on me. It always takes me a few times to get over the original opening on shows. Not bad. I don't know what to do with myself because I can't see anything. I'm just looking at my desktop on my computer. All right, I think we might be getting into the episode here soon. Okay. And almost there, I think. Okay, we're back into it. And I have it back up now. Cool. This guy again fighting Natsu, yep. I really want to know what's under Natsu's arm. Probably gonna take us like 80 episodes to find out. One hell of a beard drawn on that guy, what the hell? Is this guy blind? Oh my god, that's so funny. Oh, that was great, because it's so true. He usually doesn't, but it's crazy seeing Natsu, like, pretty serious for once, you know? It's actually kind of scary. Ooh. Oh, the song again. I love it. He's using, like, black something. Morning Star. Don't know what that means. They really like showing us. Okay, that's kind of cool. The transition to showing what group they're going to. I see. Okay. That's kind of cool. Nice. Lasana, cool, and Mira's probably there too. I like how they're all fighting and Mira just walks up. Oh, there we go. What? How? What? What the hell? Well, that's new. So she went back after that whole Tartarus fight and absorbed her? I thought she wasn't able to do that. I mean, I guess she or did a portion of her. Damn, that's badass. Cool. Urza, how are you faring up here? Don't look too good. She wasn't able to use her magic in here before. Yeah. Damn, wait, so can he actually do that? He's all the way where, that guy's all the way where Lucy is. But that would mean Lucy can't use her magic either. And she's stuck in a room with that girl. Not good. Yeah. Oh yeah, his name is Max. I was trying to think of his name, last episode. Ugh. That was weird. Don't do that sound effect while you're poking him in the butt like that. No. Oh, jeez. Come on, Mavis, you can do it. We're back to Lucy, who probably can't fight. Jesus Christ. What is this fight? Oh God. Damn. Shit. That is like crazy that she could, like, if she actually can shrink the whole city and essentially just kill everybody instantly. Ugh. Poor guy, even though I hate him. Oh, shit. That is some crazy power. She doesn't have to be touching it or anything. This is like a form of rape. Being like, I'm stronger than you, get naked. God, this is so stupid, though. You didn't have to say that, Lucy. God damn it. What is this lady? I liked her at first. That's what I'm saying. Jeez. She did say she was like interested in her or whatever last episode. Oh my God, the fan service is off the charts this episode. You can't use your magic. Oh, Jesus. What? Oh. She knows her mom? Oh, shit. Oh, jeez. How did she get out? Okay, I guess she just got out and got dressed again that quickly. Okay, sure. And now Lucy's in a damn towel, still with cat ears on. Ugh. Nice, Kana's here. Oh God. Okay, well that works, and now Ursa can use hers. That's a very simple solution to that. So if she releases her magic now, is she just gonna go back to being naked or have a towel? I don't know. I don't want to know, to be honest. Oh yes! We get to see Urza. Come on, some real fighting now. Not none of this fan service crap. Oh, Wind God armor. Whoa. Ah. God damn it, we cut away again. Okay, just beat him off screen, I guess? Poor Natsu. Sonotori! God damn it, he's still alive. I guess he didn't beat him off screen. I feel like Natsu's gonna do something big here just to get rid of him. Here it comes. No magic? Just an elbow? Oh, just raw strength. No magic. Look at that guy on the ground! maybe I'll just pretend I was beaten. Oh my god, took out an airship too! Right in front of him! Oh, yes! Oh! Oh, there's some blood. She actually did damage to him. Before he was like only taking like yeah, before like his body was sand almost. Oh, it's a blade of water? That is so cool. I don't know how it works, but that's so cool. She's not just a lowly soldier. Oh, nice. The entire city? So he's affecting them down below. What about the rest of the city? Okay, it's everywhere, I guess. So, Urza has to beat this guy, like, before the fights can really continue, I think. I guess it's he's annoying his own people too. That's good. Oh, I feel like Urza has barely gotten started too, if this is pushing him that far, you know? Interesting. Yeah. Poor Freed. Yeah. Ooh, is he like in the sand world? That's cool. I have like the surround sound so I could hear him like going around my ears like that with my headphones. That's awesome. That's so cool! Oh my god! Oh, jeez. Oh, no. Urza, you got this. Come on, Urza. No. Yes. Power of emotions, come on! Morningstar Armor, that's the title of the episode! Ooh, what is she about to do? He made an axe out of sand. Oh, she's creating a beacon so they know what to shoot! I hope you don't hit Urza too. Oh shit! Oh, he like dispersed the blast before, but he took that blast. Yeah. Oh. Nice, a Nakagami armor. Big boom booms. So is he defeated now? Nice. Sandstorm's gone at least, if anything. Alright, new outro. I do not know if I can watch, so I'm minimizing for that. Oh man. All right, I'm gonna mess around on my phone for a little bit, so I'll be looking down if you guys are wondering, for those of you full length that don't get this cut out. I'm nothing to look at. I'm a millennial. I need my technology to keep me occupied. I don't want to talk about the episode yet, just because I like to save that for the discussion, but I usually try to listen to the music and stuff. Yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of this song yet, actually. Yeah, I don't know. It's like, it's not bad. Maybe it's because all like the intro and outro I got to watch before, or I mean I didn't get to watch, I just decided to watch it, but okay, that's actually the end of the episode. Yeah, that finishes 292. Man, that episode was pretty good. I have my complaints about this episode, I definitely do, because as most people know that have seen some of my other videos and stuff, I'm not a big fan of fan service. I'm not gonna bash anybody that enjoys that kind of stuff, but it's just not like my kind of thing. Like, I'm not even a big fan of like live action fan service, you know? Like, if I wanna see, you know, tits and ass, I can go to plenty of adult websites and find it myself. I don't need to see it in my shows. When I'm watching shows, I'm there for stories. So having fan service is something that takes me out of a scene and makes me care less, which is why, like, you know, I'm not freaking out that this chick is, you know, with Lucy because she's just telling her to get naked. She's in her tub and she's naked, and it's just weird that other guy's there the whole time, and I don't know. The whole scene was a little weird. That's the And it was such a, it felt like such a long part of the episode, way longer than it needed to be. And then they finally got out of it, and Lucy's still just in a towel the whole time until she, you know, does something good, which was crushing the guy. That was fantastic. And that was really cool that she did that, which allowed her to use her magic, and it saved Urza because it let Urza use her magic as well. And yeah. So that's all I'm gonna say about that, just because like complaining probably isn't the most exciting thing to listen about, but I just had to voice my opinion there for that. I guess real quick, the only other complaint I had about the episode was like I'm kind of torn because on one hand working together is really cool, but on the other hand I wanted to see Urza beat this guy, you know? I didn't want to see someone coming in to save her because we know her, how strong Urza can be. And how is she going to continue with this fight if the first guy is someone that she can't take down alone? It's a little worrisome, but these are powerful foes. They've been saying even more powerful than before. I just hope that she would pull through and do something badass rather than getting saved by the Jupiter cannon. And I hope that doesn't become like a recurring theme where they just stall every single one of them until they can Jupiter Cannon blast them and, you know, get an advantage. But yeah, I just wanted to voice my opinion on that one too. That was another thing that was just a little like, eh, for me. But seeing Urza fight was awesome. Seeing her new wind, was it wind god armor or something like that? And then she had the water sword, which I don't know how it keeps its form, but that's really cool regardless. Which I mean, I guess her flame empress armor, she has made flames with her sword, I believe. So it makes sense that the water sword would be able to make water. It's just, you know, some form of magic that has to do with that kind of stuff. But that was really cool. And then seeing the Nakagami armor again, I'm pretty sure that's what she used to defeat Minerva in the Grand Magic Games. If I'm not mistaken, that was that armor that she used, so that was pretty cool. And then the whole Natsu and Gajiel holding back because not the big bad guys yet. There's two sides to that coin, I feel like. I understand holding back because you don't want to like use too much power and then you won't have that power later. But I think the problem with that is that if you use too little power, and you keep using too little power, too little power, too little power, and you never defeat the guy, eventually that's going to add up and end up being more than if you just put it all into one powerful attack and finished him off right away, you know, if you're capable of that. So, you know, I don't, you know, I'm not the characters, I say this a lot, and I don't know how, like, to quantify their magic power output and how much they have and how much they've used for this fight so far, but that's just something I was thinking about during the episode, was like, well, if you hold back too much, you're just gonna keep using your flames and you're eventually just gonna, like, run out from using too many weak attacks. But, you know, it was just something going through my head. In the end, they ended up beating the guy. They don't seem tired at all, and they sent the one dude flying all the way through the ship that Urza is fighting on, which is really cool. I like seeing the look on Ajil's face when his, like, captain just came, like, flying through his ship, and he's like, huh? That was pretty funny. Yeah. And then the other guy, I almost wish they didn't give us the exposition, because it was really funny seeing the far shot where you see, like, I think it showed Natsu, Gajeel, and the guy laying down, and the shocked expression on his face was so hilarious. And then they zoomed in on his face and let you see it, and then explained. But it would have been funny if from a distance they just let that be something that, like, the viewers might be able to pick up on, as the guy just being like, and he's going, like, pretending to be dead or something. And I think we could have got that by, like, the implications, but it was still a funny scene regardless. And then a really funny scene was the Happy one. That was great, where Happy was like, oh, you're actually thinking ahead for once. You've grown up so much. It's so funny because it is true. Natsu usually just goes, like, all out with everything he does and then runs out of magic, and it's just like, well, shit, I'll magically get some flames somehow because I'm lucky like that, and or eat something else and gain more magic power and do more. But this time, you know, it kind of, with that humor brought into it, it also goes to show how serious Natsu is taking this, which is pretty crazy, because it's not often we see Natsu, like, really serious. And I think that's another reason I'm gonna mention it again, even though I said I'm not going to. Another reason I'm not the biggest fan of the whole development with the fan service stuff, because seeing Natsu take things so seriously kind of makes me take things so seriously, and then it pans to this, like, silly fan service stuff, and it just takes me out of the show so much. But yeah. I'm hoping to see Mavis come up with some kind of plan. Hopefully she can overcome her, you know, fears. It's almost like this is, like, the first time she didn't know what to do and she's kind of panicking, you know, like that kind of happens with some people that are perfect with everything and then suddenly they're not perfect anymore and they spend more time freaking out about it rather than doing something about it. And you know, that might be what's going on with Mavis, but hopefully she snaps out of it and puts together, like, a really good plan soon, and we get to see some, like, cool stuff from Mavis. Even if they don't tell us until they execute it, it would just be cool seeing, like, little clips of Mavis saying, okay, these two are gonna go here, like she did in the Grand Magic Games. And there's a 90% chance that this person's gonna be here, and they turn the corner and there they are. And that was so badass in the Grand Magic Games. I want to see that again. Oh man. Yeah. So I guess I mean, that's all that really happened this episode. I feel like I didn't talk that much, and I don't really have many expectations. We had Gray, Juvia, Elfman, Lasana, and Mira going up against Wall's army, and we haven't seen Wall yet. But I'm guessing that fight, we might see them kick off against Wall a little bit next episode. I'm curious if Ajil is, like, full undefeated. I hope this is a situation where the people they fight stay defeated. Because I always hate when these fights go on so long that the people are able to get up again and then they gotta find a way to defeat him again. You know, like if this fight goes on for a really long time in like their world, like this happened during the Grimoire Heart stuff, where the first one to be defeated was that like sword guy that used solid, like kind of like or script magic, kind of like Levy, that's her name. And then the weird chicken guy that spit eggs. They were defeated first by Gajeel, and then by the end of the show, they were, or by the end of that arc, they were coming back again and fighting because they had time to recover. And I hope that's not something that happens with these Spriggan 12, because that always annoys me. It makes sense. It's not that it doesn't make sense, but it just annoys me having to like repeat the same fight again after we saw some like epic moment of defeat and stuff for a character. I feel like it lessens the impact of the original defeat when that kind of stuff happens. But yeah, I guess the only way to know what will happen there is to find out. I'm curious how Lucy and Kana are gonna fare against Brandish is her name, because they're not the strongest, you know, like Kana, I guess. I don't know how Kana's done, but her magic has never been like super impressive. It saved the day a few times, and it has done some stuff in the past, but she's not like a Natsu or an Erza or a Gray in my eyes. So, and then Lucy usually pulls stuff out of her butt and manages to somehow win a lot of the time. So maybe she can, I don't know the full extent of her power now that she can take on like the form of her spirits. I also don't know why she doesn't call out her spirits more these days. Like we've seen her call out the spirits. She called out Taurus during the Avatar arc, and she called out Loki, I think, at one point. But then the last two times, when they first fought Ajil back in their country when they were running away, she got into her like it was almost like an elven archer costume for Sagittarius, but she didn't summon Sagittarius, and I'm not sure why she didn't. And now she's in the Ram Ares. Ares the Ram. She's in her like costume, like the star dress or whatever she calls them when she transforms into the like kind of appearing like them, but she still didn't summon Ares, so I'm not sure. I wonder if it's like budget reasons not drawing another person on the screen, or if they couldn't get the voice actor again or something, because I don't know if we've seen Ares since the show began. And I don't think we've seen Sagittarius either since the show started up again. So I'm wondering if they like lost those voice actors or something, and they haven't replaced them. I don't know. Or, you know, maybe it's just not what Lucy wanted to do, but I feel like she'd be a lot stronger if she summoned her spirit, especially going against a Spriggan 12, you know? But who knows? Maybe we'll see in the next episode. That was just one of the concerns I had. And yeah, I guess if I wanna make a comment on it, another thing that really took me out of the scene was that fucking guy shoving a broomstick up the other guy's butt and it making like the fart sound. That was really honestly disturbing to me. I don't know. The humor in this show has taken like a weird turn, I feel like. I don't know. But yeah. Oh well. I still love the fights and I love the action for the most part, so I still love the show. But, you know, it feels a little off-putting when you see that stuff for me anyway. But yeah. Anyway, I think that pretty much sums up most of what happened in the episode, and I mean, most of the predictions I have are straightforward. I don't know if there's gonna be any, like, I can't really think of what any more surprises could be. I guess I'm wondering if they're gonna take out Wall and Brandish over the next couple episodes, and then give us three more coming in. Or are they gonna still be fighting Wall and Brandish when the other three arrive, or the other nine arrive, and then we're just gonna be bouncing between a lot more fights or something? But yeah, no idea. So yeah, I think that's gonna be it for this episode, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, please like the video and subscribe. I very much appreciate it. That way you can see all the new content that comes to my channel and all that and all that fun stuff. And then if you also want to check out my Patreon, where you can access full length content, so you can see the full episodes without any editing done to them. And you can also get early access on there as of now, and you can see the next episode already on Patreon if you become that tier. And also, becoming a patron, any tier of patron, just helps me out. It really will improve the channel in ways where I can, use the money that I receive from Patreon to improve things like a better webcam. And I want to improve like the setting around me eventually, where it's not just like, my room with a couple posters in the background and in my bed and stuff. I want to have like some cool stuff behind me to show off as well. I don't know how I'd do that yet. That's pretty far in the future if I were to do it, but and then also if I can justify doing this full time eventually, sometime in the distant future, if this picks up enough, then I could do a lot more shows. I could have possibly seven shows going instead of four, maybe even more, or just doing extra episodes as well. But yeah, any support is very much appreciated, guys. But even if you don't support, I still love you all. Feel free to leave comments below. Just please no spoilers at all. And I'd love to chat with you guys about what you guys thought about this episode too, even though I'm sure you're ahead by now. And yeah, so if you guys agree with any of my comments that kind of bashed the episode, or if you disagree and be like, "No, Morph, boobs are awesome," then sure. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.